Thank you for joining. Today we will discuss on how to install Virtual Matrix software. The Virtual Matrix software you can download from our website. You go to hanwa-security.com, then select products, surveillance software. Under surveillance software, you have to select version 2.1. Then go all the way down, click on software. You can download Virtual Matrix. Alright, how to download? Click on it and it will get downloaded. Make sure your Virtual Matrix is the same version as your SSM version that you have on your PC. How to check the SSM version? Open SSM Manager, click on information, you will find your version number. Alright, then you make sure you download the Virtual Matrix of the same version. Then, when you download and afterwards install, you have to just open the setup file and click next. Right? But we are going to see a few more things, which is the fundamentals of installing the Virtual Matrix application. The Virtual Matrix application is actually a combination of three different applications, which are Virtual Matrix Manager, Gateway, and Decoder. The function of manager is to design the video wall, configure the decoders, configure the monitor layouts, assign certain actions to monitors. So it's the managing application. The managing application does not require license. The second software piece is the gateway. It's actually a service. There is no physical application. It's a service that is running. Behind, it is responsible for communicating between decoder, which is connected to works monitors, and the manager. Okay. The third application is decoder application. This is the important hardware, which is directly connected to the wall monitors. You can use your own workstation, buy a license to make it a video wall decoder, or you can buy a Hanwa pre-licensed decoder. Okay, you need one gateway in your project for every 48 monitors, and the gateway you can install in any of your decoder PC or a manager PC. The manager application itself you can install in any of your client PCs. All right, it need not be that it should have a dedicated PC. All right, the decoder alone you should have dedicated PCs, which are of course connected to the wall monitors. Now when you're installing the software, you will find that it is asking you, do you want to install in multiple locations? Yes, you have to click next. And then in the manager PC or the PC client PC where you're installing the manager, make sure you install only the manager application. You can also use that same PC for gateway, it is up to you, or you can use one of the decoder PC as gateway. So here I am going to install both the manager and gateway in one of the client PCs or one of the PCs that I'm using other than the decoder. Then when you install the same Virtual Matrix on the decoder PCs, you have to uncheck these two and only select it. Virtual Matrix when you're installing this application here, right? Only select this. When you're installing here, unselect this and select only the manager and gateway. All right, now I have installed this already in my PC. And the application will look like this. Virtual Matrix. Gateway and manager, VMM and gateway. You can open the gateway, it will start running. That's a service that will start running. And you can check once the gateway whether it is running the correct IP address where it is being installed. Okay, so select that, and also the gateway IP address, you just fix it. In case your PC is having multiple IP address, make sure you fix the correct IP address. Very important, because the decoders talk to the manager through the gateway. The next, virtual matrix manager. You can open the matrix manager. All right, create one username dedicated for matrix manager in your SSM. Okay, you can create a video wall user under admin group, and I have created the same, and you can log in. All right, so this particular window will appear initially, which we just explained. All right, now the decoder I am not going to install in this PC. The decoder is some other PC, which is the manager is in PC 1, the decoder is in PC number 6. So I have installed the decoder here, and you will see once you install, it will open up like this. It is looking for a gateway, it is looking for a SSM system. So you can also do some quick check whether the IP address of the gateway decoder is correct. So my decoder IP address is 192.168.1.11. So you select that. After that, the SSM. My SSM is actually installed in 1.20, where I also installed the manager for the video purpose. So type in the correct IP address of your SSM, and that's it. After that, you can click apply. Once you have this much set up, the video decoder on a workstation requires licenses. So select start button, license manager, and then you can activate your license either online or offline method. You can check in other videos how to do online or offline activation. And once you finish the activation, you will find here that the video decoder license has been activated. VD10L has been activated. Okay, it should not show an expiry date. So mine is activated, which means it's good. In case you haven't activated, after the expiry date of 45 days, the video decoder controller will stop unless you activate it. All right, now in order to control the decoder, I need to go back to my manager, which is on my other PC. All right, now I am on my PC number one, which is having the manager. Steps are very simple. Add your gateway. My gateway is the same PC which I am using, 1.20. And wall creation. It's a very important step where you have to create a wall for your monitor. If your monitor wall has 6 monitors, example. Here in my control room, I have 6 monitors. One of them is running the decoder. Okay, I have just connected one monitor to the PC, so it's running the decoder application. All right. All right. So I have 6 monitors, right? 3 columns and 2 rows. So if you see here, 1, 2, 3 columns and 2 rows. So you create first a name, control room, 2 rows and 3 columns, register. After that, another important step is make sure you select same monitor size. Most of you are using that. After you complete this, go to decoder. What is the objective of this decoder? In your project, example, in this my project here, I have one decoder connected to one monitor. If I have another decoder connected to these two monitors, then I have another one connected to these. So I have total 3 decoders or 3 PCs connected to these monitors, right? So I have to add them to my manager application. So currently I going to add my decoder to the manager application. Done. Okay. Now Once you add, how do you know everything is fine, that it has worked or it has been added clearly is, now when I switch back, that particular monitor which was showing on looking for system manager, looking for virtual manager, now it will open up a default layout of 4x4. Okay. You can see in the monitor, the middle monitor now is looking for a camera layout. Before it was looking for a manager or the virtual matrix application, now it is ready to display monitors. Okay. Right. Now, once you add a decoder, it will detect how many monitors are connected. Now you need to address that monitor to your wall, right? My workstation, if I have two monitors and I need to address monitor one here, monitor two here on the wall. Okay, so you need to understand where the first cable is going and connecting. If your first cable from the PC is connected to the screen number one, so you go and select screen number one. If for some reason the first cable accidentally was connected to screen number two, in that case you need to go and connect it to screen number two. So you need to address it properly so you have an idea, because some projects 1, 2, 3, it can be this way, or 1, 2, 3, 4, some people count it that way. So it depends on how you want to address your monitors in the project. Okay. Now I have in my monitor wall, I am going to say this monitor is actually connected to the center one. Okay, apply. Now layout management. Layout management, do not confuse this with a monitor layout. This is a wall layout. If you see here, it's a wall layout. The entire monitor group, all right? This can be 5x5, this can be 2x2, 3x3, another 5x5. The entire set, the entire configuration is called a wall layout. All right, okay, now let's create a wall layout one. Okay, wall layout one can have this particular monitor showing a certain camera. It could be let's say a dome camera. All right, and then you can choose which layout you need. I will keep 2x2, then save. Okay, now how to check if it's working right now? This particular monitor, right now I have thrown a second camera. Now if I go to that particular video wall monitor, the particular camera is now appearing here. You can go and check even in the SSM, the PDZ camera. You can see the second monitor is now 2x2 layout and this camera is displayed here. Okay, now let's go ahead and configure the rest. Okay, double click. This is the layout. You can throw another camera here, another camera here, another camera here, and save. Before closing, save it. So this is one monitor. Similarly, you can create another layout here. The entire thing is called a wall layout, not only for one. The entire set of monitors, all the layouts combined together is called one wall layout. Now I'm going to create another wall layout. This is wall layout two. Okay. Now I decide to show only one camera, for example. Okay, one. I can do that. Save. Done. All right. Now you should see my entire monitor is now fixed to a single camera layout. Basically, it's a fisheye camera with three different zones. All right. So, for your clarification, I can put out one more camera. Let's say it is automatically changing at the back side. So this is called video wall layout, where you can remotely control the monitors using your virtual matrix application. Right? Okay. Now how do you merge monitors? In order to merge, you can decide to choose like this. So when you go in between, you find an option. Okay, so you can merge. If you want to merge these four monitors, you can merge it as one camera, then save it. Automatically, you will see one fourth of the camera is here. The remaining, if you have video wall decoders, then the remaining camera will show in the other areas. All right, so now these are actually not added to my system, that's why it's not showing. But if you have these decoders connected and added, you will start seeing the cameras from the spread across the entire monitor as one single camera, right? Okay, now once you have finished configuring, either you can drop cameras. Actually, some customers, it is preferred that you drop layouts. You would have already created layouts in your SSM, right? In SSM, there is a layout option which you would have already created. You can go ahead and drop the layout also. You don't have to create every time. You don't have to select every time a camera. You can just drag and drop a layout. Whatever layout is there, it will start appearing here. So that can be done. If you want to do monitor sequence, you can first create a sequence and say, okay, in I want to sequence between layout 1, layout 2, select apply. Okay, this is called monitor sequence. You can give it a name, 1, apply. So it's a sequence between two layouts. Go back to layout management and then minimize this. Under monitor sequence list, you will find the one you created. You can drag and drop this. So now this monitor will show every 10 seconds layout 1, layout 2, layout 3, and so on. Okay. After you have done this, you don't need manager anymore. You can even start controlling the video wall through your SSM. In SSM, there is a video wall button where you can change the layout of the video wall by just clicking the drop down menu and selecting the layout. See, the camera is changing in my wall layout. So this is my video wall monitor. It is changing. I can do that. Great. So that's all for today. If you have any further questions, please get in touch with the Hanwha team to assist and support you further. If you're having any troubleshooting issue, most likely check the firewall connection and the Windows Defender real-time protection. Disable that. Also, you can disable user access control. Okay, UAC, user access control settings, user account control. You can keep it low for the decoder PC. It will help to create the pop-ups easily. All right, thank you so much.